searching the world for more. The truest friend I have indeed. You're my best friend, I know in need. I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. The agony of being alone, fear of doing things on my own, the tests and trials that come to make me strong. The ways of trials that beat upon me. But to know, Lord, that in you I've got victory. I need you now, Lord, I need you now. Not another minute, Lord. Can't wait another day. Oh, oh Lord. Please make a way. Oh Lord, oh Lord.
This song really speaks the sentiments of my heart. I never lost my praise. I've lost some good friends along life's way. Some loved ones departed in heaven to stay. But thank God I didn't lose everything. Lost faith in people who said they cared. In the time of my crisis, they were never there. But in my disappointment, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing never changed. I'm doctor told me that I needed surgery to remove a large tumor and that it could be cancerous. But I kept on praying. And I kept on praying. And when the surgery was over, there was no cancer found. Thank you, Lord. Jesus, for my praise. Yeah, yeah.
nations on every hand. Though Satan's tried to stop me and to place my feet on sinking sand, through the pain and all of my sorrows, through the tears and all of my fears, the Lord was there to keep me, for he's kept me in the midst of it all. Not because I've been so faithful, not because I've always obeyed. No, it's not because I trusted him to be with me all of the way, but it's because he loves me so dearly. He was there. going round.
see how you were there for me, and I can say never would have made it, never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all, but now I see how you were there for me, and I can say I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you are the one I held on to, and I never,
never would have made it.
Oh, I never could have made it. Somebody just need to testify to somebody next to them. Tell them, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over what he brought me through, I realize I made it because I had you to hold on to. Now I'm stronger. Now I'm wiser, I'm better, so much better. I made it. Is there anybody in this house other than me that could declare you made it? Tell your neighbor, never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Tell them, never could have made it. Oh, I wish I had some help here. I wish I had just two or three people that would just declare it. Never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
Oh. just love to encourage myself. Sometimes I just look in the mirror and say, I'm strong. I'm wise. I am better. So much better. When I look back over what he brought me through, I realize I made it because I had you to hold on to. But I never would have made it. I never could have made it without you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lord. Oh, good God Almighty, never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Never could have made it. Sing it one more time. All I need is just one more time. Everybody say it with me.
Never would have made it.
Oh, oh, oh.
Never could have made it without
you. Leave it off the right now. I gotta turn it.
Good morning. Can everyone be seated, please? The ushers are about to do their ritual. Thank you.
Go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we knew not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Let us look to the hills of what comes from our faith. Heavenly Father, we come this morning saying thank you. Lord, we thank you for another day. Lord, we thank you for this time, for this hour, for this time of celebration. Lord, we come to celebrate our sister, our friend. Lord, for the life that she led, for the legacy that she has left behind. Lord, we come asking you to touch the family, to give them the strength, to give them the understanding of knowing that to be absent from this body is to be present with you. Lord, we thank you for this time that you have allowed us to come. And Lord, may we be a comfort to this family. May we be able to show them that you are the way, you are the truth, and you are the life. And Lord, that their loved one has only departed for a while, but soon and very soon, we will all gather together again. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we bless you, we magnify and glorify your name. We give all of these prayers to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Brother, have you found anything that we can use to perpetuate the memory of our departed member at this craft?
I hold in my hand a pair of spotless white clothes, which denote the purity of their life and the willingness to serve humanity.
Sister, have you found anything in your search that can serve as a reminder these who have passed through this silent land a little sooner than we once served in this detachment of God's army that is called Usher?
Yes, I have found a gold pin worn by members of this organization, which shows that denominational barriers have been broken and church ushers of all faith have united in one hand of Christian love.
Sister, have you found anything that we can use as a memento that these who have acknowledged the supreme of death once served in the aisles of this holy temple?
Yes, I hold in my hand an emblem of service in the house of God, the badge of a Christian leader.
These three mementos of faithful service I shall place in the archives of our organization so that unborn generations shall know that our departed sisters spent a lifetime of service in the house of God.
County Ushers Association, I'm honored today to stand before you and offer condolence on this unit. This unit Lola started me in. I used to travel with her, we would go to the meetings. There was no other happier person in those meetings when it came to the roll call of churches. And she would happily stand up when they go East End Baptist, she would go four and out.
Amen.
With pride, she stand up. Today is not a sad occasion. Today is a homegoing celebration. Yeah. No one knew that better than Lola. Lola and I went to many a homegoing celebrations together, and she knew the rules, regulations, and responsibility of an usher being there. I want to tell you guys that if there's anything I can do, just reach out to me. Joe Hardy, I'll be happy to talk to you and tell you about me and my big sister, Lola Goodman.
Amen. Amen.
Of herself in whatever way she could have took
still possess a deep and quiet dedication for ushering. She served in the state organization with unwavering devotion. She always sought ways on how to become a better usher. She sought ways in which our organization might become a better organization. Her untiring dedication and her love for her guide, her fellow man, and her church will ever serve as a beacon to those who knew her and will also serve as a beacon light to unborn generations. Whereas Lois S. Goodman demonstrated the highest ideals in this Christian pursuit through her untiring dedication. Whereas many were encouraged to pursue the path that our departed sister has chosen. Whereas, having chosen this path, it will lead to a greater Christian service. Whereas, as a departed sister's life or service would ever serve as a beacon light to guide us along this Christian path. Be ye resolved that we seek always to promote the things that she labored to promote so diligently. Be ye further resolved that a copy of this resolution be entered into the archives of our organization so that our unborn generation may know that this our Lower S. Goodman served in this detachment as pushing. Be ye still further resolved that copy of this resolution be given to the family. Thus, by order of United Church Ushers Association of Fairfield County, Sister Liza Clark, Fairfield Unit President.
On behalf of the Fairfield Unit, we say thank you. And if there's anything, Sister Liza did call last night about 10 o'clock. She will be back. If there's anything that you know that Fairfield can do, we will do it if it's in our power. We thank you for letting Lola be an usher. That was my friend, girl. That was my friend. You see, I hate her. I took her to get his hat. Me and her was the first after one of them at your church. But me and her, I took her there, and me and her, we haven't stopped. Now, Lola, you gone, baby, but I got your appointment time now. You'll still be sitting in Debbie's chair, but it'll be a minute. So I just wanted to say we love you guys, and if it's anything, just remember, keep God first in your life. And God will see you through, even through this. Okay, Lord, you left me, but I'll meet you one day.
At this time, we'll be doing our final condolences.
Got to walk on, walk on through temptation, 'cause he thankful and glad. like to go. There is no way to get back yesterday, so I had to leave. I had to smile to ease my pain. Brought me so much joy, joy beyond belief. Still I had to leave. Ooh. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for just loving me. Thank you all who care for me. Thank you all who share. That it's so very hard. I know that it's so, so very hard, hard to let it go. Whoa. So here we are. Mm-mm. One last time. Hope you don't forget all the tenderness. It's just my time to leave. I'll always be here. On that you can depend. It's just my time to leave. Oh, I love to stay, but I had to go away. It's just my time to leave. Thank you. trouble all over the world.
Close your eyes and think of me, and soon we will be there.
to go. There is no way to get back yesterday, so I had to leave. I had to smile. Brought me so much joy, joy beyond belief. Still I had to leave. Ooh. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for just loving me. Thank you all who cared for me. Thank you all who shared with me. That it's so very hard. I know that it's so, so very hard. Hard to let it go. Just my time to leave. I'll always be here. On that you can depend. It's just my time to leave. Oh, I love to stay. But I had to go away. It's just my time to leave.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Even in this, God is worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Hallelujah. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they shall comfort me. We will go as the program is listed. At this time, we will have our congregational hymn, Blessed Assurance. And I'm going to ask everyone, except for the family, to stand for the congregational hymn.
I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall therefore be in gladness in my mouth. I'm sorry. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall therefore and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me, and I delivered me from all my fears. They looked up to him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. The poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of his troubles. The angels of the Lord encamped around about them, feared him, and delivered him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Bless his man that trusteth in him. Oh, fear the Lord, ye saints, for there is no want them that fear him. The young lions no lack and suffer hunger, but they seek the Lord, shall not want any good thing. Come, ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What a man he has desired, life and love of many days, that he may see good. Keep the tongue of evil and thy lips of seeking guile. Depart from the evil and do good. Seek peace and purity. I have read Psalms 34, verses 1 through 14. The Lord bless his holy word.
If we should ask each person here to say something about Lola, Sister Goodman, we would hear the exact thing over and over again. Even the scripture that I'm going to read today has been read this morning already. And I'm reading John 14, 1 through 7 from the NIV. And it reads, "Do not let your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If it were not so, wouldn't I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that where you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we don't know where you're going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." The word of God for the people of God. Amen. Praise be to the name of the Lord.
Amen. Let us pray. In times like these, we need a Savior. In times like these, we need an anchor. So be very sure that your anchor holds and grips the solid rock. That rock is Jesus. He is the one. Jesus, the only one. Lord God, we come at this hour. We come, oh God, to say thank you for the life and legacy of Sister Lola Goodman. Lord, we thank you that we had the opportunity and the privilege, oh God, to know her. Some of us are family members, others are acquaintances, but Lord God, whatever it is that we had, that we came in contact with us, Lord God, we say thank you. Oh, God, we thank you, God, for the life that she lived. We thank you, oh, God, for her dedication to service. We thank you, oh, God, for her faithfulness. Oh, God, she was a faithful servant. Stood by the door every Sunday morning, greeting people as they entered into the sanctuary. Lord God, we thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for the life of Lola Goodman. Oh, God, she was your servant. Yeah. No greater servant than to serve the people of God. Yeah. Lord, I pray for this family. Yeah. Yeah. I pray, oh, God, that you would touch them in ways that only you can. Oh, God, we know that there's pain right now. And oh God, we know that there are tears right now. We know, though God, that there's hurt right now. But Lord God, we know that you are someone that they can lean on. In the midnight hour when nobody else around, you can lean on you. So God, we thank you for this family. We lift them up at this hour, oh God. Let them know, God, that there's nothing that you cannot do. Oh God, when they need you, they can call on you. You're but a prayer away. So God, we thank you. Lift this family up. Touch them right now. Touch them, oh God, as only you can. Let them know, God, that you will neither leave nor forsake them. That you are God that will hold to your promises. Let them know, God, that they can hold to God's unchanging hand. Lord God, we thank you right now. Lord God, we glorify in your presence right now. Touch right now. Touch right now in ways that only you can. Touch! Lord God, touch right now. We thank you. We thank you, God. We glorify you in this hour. We lift you up in this hour. For you are our God. There's no God but you. And so, God, we thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you. Be in this service. Let your spirit take over and have your way in this service. Lord God, we thank you and we bless your name. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. And thank God.
Our core team will come and render a selection, followed by the acknowledgments of condolence by Sister Kim Lanham. You will then read the obituary silently, and then the letter from the church resolution, Deacon Cindy Wilson.
Strength like no other. morning, church. Good afternoon to the family. My sincere condolences. Wishing you peace and comfort at this sad time, the senior missionary ministry of the Eastern Baptist Tabernacle Church, Deacon Loretta Williams, president. Each soul leaves a legacy of love. Each memory becomes a bridge to comfort, which connects to heart, to one heart, to another forever. May hope sustain you, friends surround you, and love give you strength. Okay. So let's give thanks for this good soul who touched the lives of so many. Hoping your faith in that you will give your comfort at the time in this grief. And our deepest sympathy, the Eastern Baptist Church Deacon Team Number 4, Jeff Robinson, Betty Till, James Till, Cynthia Wilson, Richard Rice, and Peter Mosley. The sadness in the passing of your loved one is felt by many. May the thought of knowing that friends share in your sadness be of comfort to you. I just need to say one more thing, I'm sorry. You know how the deacons, I mean not the deacons, the ushers go around and they always whisper in your ear and you know they're telling you a little secret or so. So Lola, at my mom's funeral, Lola came over there and she whispered in my ear and she said, "Don't let the pastor tell you that you only get 2 minutes to talk about your mom." Had to tell it.
Goodman family, you have my deepest condolences. I too will also miss Lola. December 31st, 2022. An expression of condolence to the Goodman family and friends in memory of Lola Goodman. Great sadness and loss fills our hearts as we, the pastor, congregation of East End Baptist Tabernacle Church, address these words to you. Though there is not anything we can do at this moment to ease your pain, please know that we share these moments with you. We will continue to pray. Though there is nothing, anything that we can do to ease your pain, please know that we share these moments with you. We will continue to pray your strength during this time of bereavement. Our prayers is that we will continue to trust God and to hold to God's unchanging hands. The word of God tells us to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Amen. This is the assurance we take into the future. The East End Baptist Tabernacle Church family will continue to pray and keep you in our prayers. In the battle to win, the Reverend Dr. C.L. Stallworth, Senior Pastor, Cynthia Wilson, William Minor, Deacon Ministry Chairpersons, Steve Dillon, Trustee Ministry Chairperson. You have our deepest sympathy. Please call us at any time if there's anything that we here at the Tabernacle can do for you. God bless you.
Thank you, Deacon Wilson. At this time, Sister Lawania Martin will come with the reading of the citation from the state of Connecticut, followed by Ernest Newton, Brother Fred Phillips, Sister Kitty Toomer, and Deacon William Minor with memorial tributes.
Amen, amen. Given out to God, who's the head of my household. This is a tough day for me, as well as everyone else. So just bear with me. I bring you greetings from the state of Connecticut. Goodman family, you have my sincerest condolences. It reads as follows. The General Assembly in memoriam, be it known to all that the Connecticut House of Representatives extends its sincerest condolences and expressions of sympathy to the Goodman family and East End Baptist Church on the passing of Miss Lola Goodman. It reads, we share your grief at the passing of Lola, Sister Lola Goodman. Lola's love for her church was so faithfully displayed through her service with the usher ministry, supper program, and so many places where she had made the world a better place. We acknowledge the immense role she served in the life of Representative Charlie Stallworth, which provided him the opportunity to serve others as well. May Lola's good works and great efforts in church, community, and politics serve as a light for others to see and emulate. Presented by State Representative Charlie Stallworth on this day, signed by our State House Representative Speaker Matt Ritter and Secretary of the State Denise Murrow. Thank you for your time.
First, I say namaste, and what namaste means that the divinity in me salutes the divinity in you. So namaste, because we all have that divinity.
Yeah.
I have the privilege of reading a citation from the city of Bridgeport, but I'm going to ask if it's all right with Dr. Stallworth. Councilwoman Smith is in the house. I know you're working for Baker, but you got to put your council hat on. Come on up. So I'm going to ask Councilwoman, because you all know the civic work Lola did in the community. She never was too heavenly minded and no earthly good. So I will let her read this and then I'll have a few words.
Strong glasses. And it reads as thus, whereas Lola S. Goodman was born in Winnsboro, South Carolina, and in 1960, Lola became a resident of Bridgeport, Connecticut, and Lola worked as a dedicated community outreach worker for Bridgeport Mental Health for over 35 years. Lola was very involved in city politics and served as a member of the Bridgeport Democratic Town Committee for the 136th District. She also involved in numerous civic and local community organizations and boards. In 1979, Lola became a member of the East End Baptist Tabernacle in Bridgeport. She served with dedication in several ministries within the church and was also passionate about serving. In 1984, she became president of the Senior Usher Board. In addition, Lola was a member of the Fairfield County Usher Board. Lola's family and friends would cherish her beautiful life, especially her beloved mother, Maddie S. Turner, son James F. Sanders Sr., grandchildren James Jr. and Brittany. great-grandchildren Carter J. Sanders and her extended family. Now, whereas Joseph P. Ganim, mayor of the city of Bridgeport, joined by the East End Baptist Tabernacle Church, honor the memory of Lola for her many years of dedication service to our city, and do hereby proclaim Saturday, December 31st, 2022, as Lola S. Goodman Day.
Now, I've seen a lot of things in my day, but I ain't never seen nobody get a day on their burial. Lola was a bad shut your mouth. Let me say that Lola was a dear friend to me. And I can remember coming home for a vacation I had for 4.5 years. I came to see Lola. And Lola wrapped her arms around me and said, "Brother, I'm glad you're back." And she was always bossy. She said, "I just want you to know to get ready because you're going back." I said, "Back to jail?" She said, "No, dummy. You got to get back involved and fight for our people." I was hurt when I heard that Lola passed. Because anytime you came to East End Baptist, Lola let you know she was the head in charge. And we've had many discussions. I'm telling you, if Lola, I don't think she disliked people, but she always let you know where she stood. And the worst thing you could do is cross her. But I gotta believe this today. Just think about this for a moment. We always read to be absent in the body is to be in the presence of God. Just think where Lola is. She gonna bring the New Year's in the presence of God. And I gotta believe. See, I won't bring it in yet. So that means I got to wake up in the morning, if God spares me, to the troubles of the world. But Lola is somewhere. Lola is somewhere in the presence of God. I can only imagine. And I always say this, what it must be like in the presence of the Almighty God that we've prayed to, we've talked to, but to actually be in his presence. So if Lola had to make a choice, she love y'all. But I can guarantee you, she wouldn't want it, she ain't coming back. So to the family, we loved her, but God loved her best. And just remember this as I close. It's never how long you live, but it's what you do while you live. And so even though I'm sad, I'm happy. Because God picked the best usher to usher folk in. That's a blessing. Thank you and God bless you.
Morning, church. Morning. Let me just start by saying we're not here to mourn a death. We're here to celebrate a life. Yeah. And if anybody know how to celebrate a life, it was Lola. Yeah. As the cold of the snow in the time of harvest, so is a faithful messenger to them who send him, for he refreshes the soul. Mm-hmm. My path first crossed with Lola at the Greater Bridgeport Community Mental Health Center. And I was at the time, I was a human resource worker. And when I looked at the people who were working at the center at the time, I immediately made a phone call to Hartford and spoke to the chief affirmative action officer. And I said, listen, the people working at this center, the demographics don't reflect the people in the center. I said, we got a city full of black folks, and we don't have a center full of black folks working down here and represented. So I went to work immediately. And one of my main resources was Lola. And upon making new hires, I would not listen so much to the supervisors, but I would consult with my good friend Lola. And Lola would tell me who's doing what and who's not doing what. And this person ain't no good, and that person ain't no good. And you really need to get rid of so-and-so. But if you I would say if you look under the dictionary, but in these day and times, if you would Google friend, you would see Lola. Amen. You would see a big picture of Lola smiling in the background. That's just who she was to me. She was the type of person who, if I lost my cell phone, and I don't have any contacts, I always knew Lola's contacts. I could call Lola. I didn't have to look up Lola's number. I knew Lola's number by heart. And I had Lola listed under two numbers, Lola Goodman and Foxy Lola. And if I knew I was coming up to Bridgeport in this area and I wanted to hang out and, you know, go out and we have a little wine and party or whatever, I'd call Foxy Lola up. Because I know when Lola stepped out, Lola's going to step out in style and she was going to be looking good. And I say, okay, Lola, we can look good together. Let's do it. All right. And we'd have a good time. And you know, at my role after retirement, you know, see, churches never get the memo that you're retired. So they immediately put me to work at my church, and I subsequently became the steward board chair. So our narrative and our conversations changed with each other over the years. So Lola would call, and we'd share various stories. So Lola told me one day, she said, Fred, I said, yeah. The kids call me the mean usher. I said, well, there's nothing wrong with being the mean usher. Because kids today have a problem figuring out what the difference is between mean and someone who's disciplining you. And when you're disciplined, that could save your life.
That's right.
You know, we used to get mad at the nosy neighbors who used to tell everything, you know, before we got home, you know, then we get beat again, and like the beatings never stop. But with that type of discipline and that type of an individual who you think as a child is being mean, that person is actually helping you. And I guarantee you as a child, as you grow up in life, as you develop and enter maturation, that's the person you're going to remember. That's the person you're going to remember, and that's the person you're going to be like, oh, okay, I get it now. You know, imagine what type of city Bridgeport would be. Imagine what type of state the state of Connecticut would be if we had more mean ushers. I'm just gonna say in closing that I love Lola. Lola's the only person that could call me anytime, and I'm gonna be there for her because I know it was the same way with her. She'd have me and Pearson down there playing jackleg mechanic, trying to fix one of her cars, or the car won't start. I come from the Hartford area. Lopez would come from the Naugatuck area. And then we put whatever tools we could find, because Lola had everything. I guarantee you, if you look long enough, you're going to find just what you're looking for in that garage. You just had to be patient. But, you know, she was a good friend. She'll be missed. And I just want to thank God for Lola, for sending us Lola. And I want to thank the family for sharing Lola. Thank you.
I'm going to try hard to say things about Lola that a lot of you already know and a lot of you don't know. But I met Lola over 53 years ago when I came to Connecticut. And she took me under her wing, introduced me to a lot of people. We did a lot of things together. That's kind of why I'm into politics a little bit. Because we would knock on doors to get people to, y'all remember Father Penning Village? Knock on doors to get people to register. Then we had to go knock on doors and beg them to go vote. And then we started the Martin Luther King birthday in January of every year. And that was a big thing for us. We got all dressed up, we was looking good, and we went down to the Holiday Inn, and it was wonderful. I met a lot of people. And they would say, Lola, who is that? She said, that's Kitty from the city. Right. I don't know why she started calling me Kitty from the city, but it was okay. And Lola and I have been around each other a long time. We didn't always agree. We argued. We had problems. But the one thing about Lola, when I needed her, she was there. She was always there, and there were plenty of times I needed her. I'm gonna miss her. And Lola, Kitty from the city, is gonna miss you.
Lord willing, and the creek don't rise. I've heard that expression many times from Sister Goodman. She would always tell me, and I would say, Lola, are you going to such and such a place? She said, Lord willing, and the creek don't rise. But I want to take a moment and simply say about Lola and the Christian Education Department. I was one of her teachers in the Bible study class. We met on Monday night on the conference line, and Lola was faithful. As a matter of fact, Lola was so faithful, she would just dominate the conversation. As a matter of fact, she talked more than I did. But that was Lola. And so we had a situation where we were not getting our material on time, and so I came into church and I said, Lola, we don't have books. And she says, well, teach from the Bible. I said, okay, that's a good idea. That's what I'll do. I said, you have been after me for all these times to teach. This is your opportunity to teach. She says, okay. So finally, when we got the books, I said, Lola, you still going to teach? She says, no, I haven't had time to read the material. Okay. But I want to simply say that Lola was an avid reader and study of the Bible. Yeah. She was at my class on Monday, and then she would go to the Teals class on Thursday, I believe it was, right, James? She would show up at that class, And the only reason she didn't go to the Wednesday night class is because that was for men only.
All right.
But she was an avid reader of the Bible, and she kept me sharp because she was always asking questions. She asked questions about almost everything. And so I would do my best, and I tell her, look, if I don't have the answer, I go look it up. She says, okay. And so that's how we got along. And every time I think about Lola, I laugh because Lola was fun. And the most recent occasion that I remember with Lola was about a week or two ago, we had a musical here. And we were all sitting here. I was sitting in the back after we had sang, And so the praise team, we had a dance group that got up to dance. And they were down front dancing. So I'm sitting in the back, and all of a sudden I hear this noise in the back of me, and there's Lola. She's dancing right along with them. And I said, what are you doing? She said, well, if they can dance, I can dance too. Thank you.
Thank you to all of you for your memories of Lola. I'm sure we all have many memories of her. That Deacon Minor, she was in my Wednesday night Bible class. And she was talkative too in my class. One thing Lola would talk to me about was prayer. She would always say, you know, I didn't know how to pray, and I was scared to pray. But she said, now you ask me to pray, and I'll be the first one there to say a prayer for my brothers and my sisters. Lola left many, many memories, good memories. She knew how to get you straight in a loving way. And she knew how to be the example and what you needed at the right time. And we're all going to miss her. At this time, Kenya Lee Erskine will come and minister us through song, followed by the eulogy from none other than our senior pastor, the Reverend Dr. C.L. Stallworth.
Grace and peace. My deepest condolences to the family. I love Lola. She was so much fun. And my mother is really, really missing her. So keep her in your prayers. I'm only human. I'm just a woman. Help me believe what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, help me to take one day at a time. There are some ways. I'm sorry. Forgive me, thou. Woman, help me believe what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway.
remember when he walked the streets among men. If you're looking below, God, you know it's worse now than then. People stealing and robbing.
I'm going to ask everybody to stand, except the family, to receive our senior pastor, the Reverend Dr. C.L. Stallworth.
Tell Dr. Annie I said hello and take good care of you. And if you want me to ship you some soup down there, I will. Love you. Miss you. Get better. You notice I didn't text you. I should have texted you. Talk to you later. Ciao. Hope you feel better. Love you. I had a cheesecake at time to tell our doctor. Tell us that she can't come over for Christmas. I think I have to eat it and give it away. But let me know she's coming. So I'll see you later. Ciao.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. That was Lola's last voice mail left on my phone. And of course, when I contacted her back, she had slipped to the other side. But it goes to show you better watch what you leave on somebody's phone. They may play it at your funeral. I weep today because I have human reason to weep. And I'm sure in this eulogy I would hit some rough spots. And for those who know I preach a eulogy about 7 minutes, that ain't gonna happen today. A friend of mine said, I called him a couple of weeks ago to let him know I was praying for him as one of their faithful members passed. And he said, Stallworth, I told God, if you had checked in with me, I got at least three that I would have sent you if you had left this one. I said, Doc, I know we say that sometimes, but I'm not sure if we should say that. That's a little harsh. All right. And then Lola passed. All right. And I said to God, God, you know what Jonathan told you the other day? I said, I can make you a better deal. Because Lola indeed touched so many lives, so many folk are here today, as you hear. On the voice mail, Dr. Tandy and the kids, and Lou, and my press person who's here. My mind is going blank on Desmond, I know so well. But Lola was that kind of person. And she helped to decorate this church along with Sister Till. I'm sure maybe somewhere deep in her spirit, she was preparing to leave in the way that only Mrs. Goodbar could leave. I take my foot in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 1 and 5. Second Corinthians chapter 5, verses 1 and 5. And verse 1 says, "For we know," if, and it could have said when, "if the earthly temple we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God."
Oh, yeah.
"Eternal in the heavens, not built by human hands." And then verse 5, "Now the one who has fashioned us for this very purpose is God, who has given us a spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come." Let me pause just a second to acknowledge the ministers who are here, Bishop Plumber, Reverend Harris Presiding, and so many others. I'm going to ask all the ministers, wherever you are, just to stand where we are in the sanctuary. God bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you. And to this family, I greet you. Permit me to be personal in this eulogy. And I have labeled it Lola Goodman's Eulogy. And the G is for good. And as I draw my experiences, and I'm sure this family can echo, I have to first of all say that Lola was a good neighbor. If you'd been to Lola's house, if you've been to the parsonage, if you stand in Lola's back door and keep walking, you walk right into the parsonage. And if you're in the parsonage at the front door and you keep walking, you walk right into Lola's back door. Moving here 17 years ago, and I discovered a member lived across the street. I thought that was one of the worst things. It's like going to church and going home and have the church just follow you home. I'm like the preacher who preached here not a while ago, Bishop Plummer, like things he used to do, he don't do anymore. I'm like the preacher who preached here a few Sundays ago that said, "Some things I used to do, I don't do as often." So I didn't want a member living across the street. I thought that was just something I had done in my life that God was punishing me. I'd heard of so many pastors who had lived in parsonage and members who lived next door and that were busybodies. And I was troubled by that. And I found myself glancing over. And I've told this story before, you know it. And more, I glanced over. It looked like Lola was in her kitchen looking out the window at me. What meaneth thou by this? It's like if in the morning I looked over, there that head was in that window. Noonday, that head, I had gotten to the place where I would wake up at night and run to the window and look to see. And bless God, even at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning when I looked over in that window, that head looking back at me, and Lola, being the neighbor, invited me over to eat. And when I got to her kitchen table, I had to laugh. I said, "Lola, I owe you an apology. Because I've been calling you not just the mad usher, mean usher, but I've been calling you the," I can't tell you what I told her, but I said,
I've been calling you a nosy neighbor. But it wasn't you looking at me. You got a flower pot right over this sink. And this flower pot looked like your head looking out at me. And only like Lola can say, well, if you thought I was looking over here, over there, you must have been looking. But I found out and I discovered over these past 17 years that Lola was a divine placement as a neighbor. That God said in God's wise providence, I got a little country boy who's coming up from Beatrice, Alabama. He's going to need somebody to watch over him. His mama is gone. He's away from his family. He gets involved in church, but he needs somebody who will be there. So God placed Lola in that place even before I got here. She was a good neighbor. Neighbor. And now I look over at that house and know she's gone. I said to myself, I don't care who moved in it, I ain't gonna like you. Borrow no sugar from me. That's Lola's house. You shouldn't even be there. Lola was a good neighbor. But not only was Lola a good neighbor, Lola was a good provider. That one time we're going over to get food, started over a decade of provisions. And even those times when we knew we should not have been eating, what we were eating. Lola said, well, for my pressure, I take a little vinegar as if that was gonna fix something. Well, I took my medicine. I guess I'll take a little vinegar, too. She was a provider. And she was a provider for wisdom. I remember when I first ran for office again, she called me over, and Lola called you over, you go, right? And I went over, and Lola, Senator Ernie, Lola said to me, she said, I hear you're running for office. And I said, yes. Yeah. She said, well, let me tell you something about politics. Now, I can't tell you exactly the way Lola told me, but you've been blacking around church long enough to fill in the gaps. Lola said, you watch politics because a person will cut their mama's anatomy off. She was a provider of wisdom. She also was a provider as the party planner. Lola was party planner. She would, and church folk, if you didn't party with her, you missed it. I know some of y'all got the sneaking party, but Lola was the party planner. She made sure we had provisions for the party. Lola called me one day, and she always would leave a message, Charlie, baby. And she called me, she said, call me back. And I called her back. She said, urgent, call me back. I called her back, and Lola said, I got us two TVs. She said, they were selling them at the dog track, going out, closed it down. I got one for you, and I got one for me. I sent the thing, Tim is here somewhere. I'll send Tim over to get it. She said, no, you got to send more than one person. Lola had bought me a TV so big, it was bigger than the parsonage. She was a provider. Provided me more food and became my food savior. Because she would come over and season my food and say, if you put enough onion in it, at some point it'll get the tasting right. We've all had her cabbage that was so finely cut. And her fried corn that was baptized with pepper. And her sweet tea that would give a mannequin diabetes.
say, I want everybody to know I got sugar. And when she tried to get me to eat cheesecake, I said, I don't eat cheesecake. She started making it for Dr. Tanya. She said, well, she eat cheesecake. I'm going to make her some cheesecake and better not give you any. Lola was a provider. She was a good neighbor. Lola also was a good protector. Let me tell you, I can tell it now. If I had known what she told Kim, I'd have told it earlier while she was still living. But many people tried to take advantage of Lola's proximity to me. And so when they couldn't get me, they would call Lola. And said, Lola, I'm trying to reach your pastor. And Lola would say, well, I don't live over there. And the reason I know she would say it, I would be right there at her kitchen table eating. So whatever you said about me, I heard that too. See, I'll be right there. Recently, Lola was in another church. So she attended all the funerals. And recently, she was at another church. And one of the members of that church said, I came to your church two Sundays. Your pastor wasn't even there. Your pastor ain't never. Lola's way old. Like 17 years, she never got my name right. She always put an extra S in my last name, Stallsworth. And she said, Stallsworth is my pastor. Talk about your pastor. But don't talk about it. Stallsworth, my pastor. She was a protector. One Sunday before the pandemic, a guy came to church and was starting some problems, and police came and arrested him. And the next Sunday, Lola came to church, and she came to the office, and she said, look in my purse. She said, look, just look in the purse. And she opened the purse, and Lola had what looked like a two-shooter. It was a pistol, but it wasn't about that big. It looked like a... I said, Lola, what are you going to do with that? She said, well, I just want you to know I got your back. Lola was a protector. She would often call me and she would say, Reverend, let up the window shade so I can see what's going on over there. I said, well, you closed your garage so I couldn't see what's going on over there. She said, well, you don't tell my business, I won't tell yours either. Lola was a protector. My sister Barbara would often come to town, and she and Lola would fuss and fight and then get in the car and go shopping. And Barbara said to Lola one day, said, Lola, you the reason my brother haven't found a wife. You the problem. Lola looked at me and said, Reverend, I guess she won't be coming next year.
But finally, and I take my seat. Finally, and I take my seat. Lola was also a good mother and a big sister. Not only to her family, but to her family that she loved dearly. But she was also a good mother and a big sister. I started just to say good mother, but Lola and I parted in ways that I couldn't have parted with my mama, so. And you're right, brother, because she was just a little, who we going to invite to the party? Oh, we ain't going to invite so-and-so, because so-and-so talks too much. But Lola was like a good mother, a big sister. First time I had COVID, Lola made me some soup. And as you see, she was ready to make some more. She made me some soup, and she called me. Now, Lola lives 30 seconds walking. But she would drive over to the house. And Lola brought me some soup. And Lola was so afraid of COVID. She said, Reverend, don't come out until I'm back in the car and I pulled away. Mother, she was a big sister. Only time I've been hospitalized in this city, and I got ill, got too hot and got ill, and Lola took her PT Cruiser and carried me to the emergency clinic there. When we got to the emergency, whatever the thing is called, and they said they need to take me to the hospital by ambulance, I could look out the back window, and as the ambulance was weaving, so was Lola in that PT Cruiser. Decades ago, when I went through a divorce, and John Lee Taylor's words were ringing after I left the court, some will remember. It's cheaper. And I was too broke to pay attention. And I was just trying to get out the courtroom before East End showed up, so I just agreed to everything. And what I had left, in a broken spirit, feeling depressed, Dr. Quarles was in Lola's house when I had this conversation. I get up every Sunday morning, put on a tailor-made suit and come to church and preach and go back home and sleep on a box spring and a quilt, because it was all I had left. And I tried to shield it from anybody, knowing I would get through it. I tried to shield it with anyone. And one day, being over Lola's house, Dr. Quarles was there. And some kind of way it slipped out. I'm going home and take a nap on my box spring. And Lola called it and said, what? I said, oh, nothing. She said, Reverend, let me see where you're sleeping. And we walked over to the parsonage. And Lola said, Reverend, go pick you a bed. Go to the store and get you a bed. Good set of mattress. Take my credit card. Don't worry about if or when paying me back. Just take care of this. All of us are good. Good mother, big sister. But in all of this, and I take my seat, in all of this, we can't get away from the reality that we live in a tent that has a date with destiny of death, that we cannot reject or avoid. But the scripture says that God has given us a deposit. And whenever you make a deposit, you can always take out what belongs to you. Lola, God had made a deposit. And God simply pulled back what belonged to God. Lola's last text to me, when she knew I couldn't be at church, Lola sent me a text and said, yeah, there it is right there. You know, that's major texting for Lola. She said, get well. And then, can I preach on Sunday? You know, I blocked out my response. But, Bad, I want to reconsider what I said. And I want to say, Lola, yes, you can preach on Sunday. But don't worry about preaching to mere humans. Don't worry about preaching to flawed flesh. And don't worry about preaching to disgruntled souls. You have another audience. Lola, you can preach on Sunday. But do me a favor when you preach. Tell God that I said thank you. Lola, you can preach on Sunday. But when you preach on Sunday, tell God that East End said thank you. Lola, you can preach on Sunday. But when you preach on Sunday, tell God your family said thank you. If you don't mind, right now, if you will help me talk to Lola and say, Lola, you can preach on Sunday. But tell God we said thank you.
Pastor Starworth, I always hate up getting up behind you because you always know how to tell a story. And you know what? You're one in a million. Because I know a lot of preachers that can have that kind of neighbor. So I don't think God's going to bless you twice with a neighbor and a member like Lola. You know, there's so many people here and come out and pay respects to Lola. I mean, everybody in here has got a story to tell about her. I know y'all do, because I got one too. But, you know, some of the stories we can share, and some of them we're going to have to keep to ourselves. But you know, the wonderful thing that we have is just that God blessed us to be able to have that relationship with Lola. Yeah. You know, I was looking at this poem on the back, and you know what I said, this really, really speaks to Lola. So whenever we're thinking about her, and she's on your mind, remember this poem, because that's what's going to get us through the days, and it's going to continue to strengthen this family and stuff, knowing who she was and how she used her gift to bless everyone. And I know this church is going to be, you know what? We're going to get through it. You're going to get through it. And you know what? Just in knowing that she was a member here and how she brought season and strength to this church. Yeah. So at this time, I ask that you come and join us as we now proceed to the Park Cemetery where we will have the interment. We ask our pallbearers if we can come line up over here, ushers. And for those of you that will be attending the graveside service, turn on your headlights and flashers and follow as directed. In respects to those that are in the wait until the family has processed out. Thank you.
I want to do something just in memory of Lola. I want all of these ushers. Where are the ushers? Just raise your hand wherever you are. You all know how you used to march before the pandemic for the offering? I want the usher who has the most rhythm. If you ain't got no rhythm, we're going to take your usher card. You get at the back of the line. But I want all the ushers to form a line and march around the wall to my extreme right and come on around this way the way you do, the way you used to do it when we used to do the offering. We need a little more upbeat for that. They need some dancing. Yeah, they need some offering music for that. Yeah. Y'all know the march you used to do, right? It's been 3 years. That's it. Every time y'all come to East End, that's the Lola's March, henceforth and forever. That's it. That's it. That's it. Come on, let's usher Lola out of here. Come on, come on. In one accord, every praise, every praise. Come on, it's to our God. That's it, that's it.
Every praise is to our God.
Yeah, every
word of worship
and one accord.
Every praise,
every praise, every praise,
every praise
is to our God.
To our God. Sing hallelujah to our God.
Sing hallelujah.
To our God,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God.
Every
word of worship,
one accord,
one accord.
Every praise,
every praise, every praise is to our God.
Come on, God, my Savior, come on.
God, my Savior.
That's it, God.
God, my healer.
Every praise.
God, my deliverer. Yes, He is.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is. Yes, He is.
God, my Savior.
God, my Savior.
God, my
healer. Every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship is one accord.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise is to our God.
Yeah.
God, my healer.
Yeah, yeah.
God, my deliverer.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is. Yes, He is.
God, my Savior.
God, my Savior.
God, my healer.
God, my healer.
God, my deliverer.
God, my deliverer.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is.
Yes,
He is.
Yeah.